Today, we will be doing another fantastic Harry Potter science experiment. We will be recreating the Wingardium Leviosa. Doesn't it sound cool?
Yeah!
So stay tuned and let's get experimenting!
For this charms lesson, you will need the following supplies. Some feathers, paper clips, some fishing line, strong magnets, two craft sticks, electrical tape or any other tape that is nicely colored, and you will also need a way of anchoring. We will be using some building blocks. In the first book, Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, there is a great scene where the young wizards are learning this spell in charms class using feathers. So let's recreate this charms lesson. Step 1. Take your magnets and stack them up. Now practice by testing your magnets with your paperclip to see how strong the draw is. You want the paperclip to jump to the magnet. Step 2. Place your magnets between two jumbo craft sticks and tape them into place. Your wand is ready. Step 3. Now let's prepare the feather. Take a paperclip and tie the fishing line to it. You want about 4 to 6 inches of fishing line. Step 4. Now anchor the end of the fishing line that doesn't have the paperclip. We placed ours between the building blocks. Finally, slide your feather into the paper clip. You are now ready for charms class. Step 5. Hold your wand near the feather. It should jump up and stick to the wand at first, but slowly lift up and the feather will levitate below your wand. By keeping the feather anchored, it will try to lift to the magnets, but the string will hold it in place, allowing you to keep your magnets a short distance away and cause the feather to float. With the Wingardium Leviosa spell, you will be able to move the feather around a bit and see how far you can move your wand away from the feather before it falls.
Thank you for watching. See you all next time.
Goodbye, future scientists.